Gentlemen, welcome back to the T. Shanley Starting a Business, Building a Brand Vlog. This one, big number 263. So, what do you think of that light? I normally don't have it like in screen when I'm doing this. Is it ambiance or should I get rid of it? Leave it for this one? All right, anyway. Gentlemen, here's the deal. Today, I want to do two things. The first thing, I want to tell you about this bad boy. This is officially the mega box that you guys can grab by hitting that link down below, tell you what's in here, and the deal in a second. The second thing I want to do is go over some of your business questions. There was a question that our friend Kadar Awad actually asked that I saw about how have I changed or have I changed since starting to post videos. And the answer is, man, I have changed in many, many ways. And some of them are good, some of them are bad. And today I just like to talk a little bit about that. But also there were some other amazing business questions that I'd just like to get into. But first, let me tell you about this bad boy. All right, so the Mega Box, this is our big Cyber Monday, Black Friday holiday deal. All right, so it comes in this big, super sexy box. You're like, damn, what's in there, Alpha? Well, I'll tell you what's in there. 12 freaking things are in here, right? I'm going to, whoa, handsome, yes. All right, so what you are getting in the Mega Box, I'll tell you about this in a second. You are going to be getting, right, you're going to be getting a bamboo T. Shanley soap holder for the shower. It's got the notches so that like water like slides off so your soap or your bars don't get all sudsy and slimy and like nasty and your wife or boyfriend or whoever isn't like, ew, it's gross, all right? So the other thing you're going to get is a scrub body bar. This is a big scrub body bar. Something else, the wash body bar. This is the big wash body bar. You're also going to get a lip balm, which is amazing. And if you guys haven't tried the lip balm, it literally is one of my favorite T. Shanley products. Hands, hand moisturizer. Tis the season for dry, cracked hands. Gentlemen, you can't be palsy with those spicy senoritas and your hands be all like nasty and cracked. And so hands is amazing. This stuff is incredible. It's not like super oily or greasy. This stuff is amazing. You're also gonna get this. It is a travel dot bag. Open that up, right? It's got the hooks. You can hang this bad boy up. Inside, you're gonna have a level 3 system, which comes with, in no particular order, super serum, which is amazing. You're gonna get the PM moisturizer to keep you handsome while you sleep, AM moisturizer with the SPF 20, keep you handsome and protected. Scrub, eyes, eye cream for dark circles, wrinkles. I just spit on you, sorry. And last, but definitely not least, wash. So you're like, damn, all this grooming goodness. Normally, regular price, $124, which is an incredible deal considering the level of quality that you are actually getting. But the price for you right now, while supplies last, $59.99, under $60. Gentlemen, that's like a 50 plus some savings. Hit the link down below and grab one of your mega boxes. Gentlemen, the mega box doesn't have to be a subscription. You don't have to be a subscriber. The other incredible thing, guys, is that this could make an amazing holiday gift. So if you've got somebody in your life who is a dude who wants to be handsome or just would like some like really badass grooming products, like if you haven't tried these two bars, guys, I'm telling you, you are gonna love it. The man in your life is gonna love it. Buy one, buy two, buy six, buy whatever you want. The fact is, the offer is going on now. It ends on Monday. If you're interested, hit the link down below and grab a mega box today. Actually, I better check to make sure that you can actually buy multiple mega boxes. I don't actually know that you can't. Let's see. Boom. Let me see. Wait for it. Hold on. Add the cart. How many? Oh, shit. I think you can buy multiple, but it doesn't allow you to buy multiple like right here. So you're gonna have to like buy one and then come back and buy another and then buy another. So little inconvenient, but the fact is, gentlemen, the deal is sweet. Seriously, $59 for 12 products. Gentlemen, hit the link, grab it today. Now what I'd like to do is get to some of your business questions. I would like to start with the question that Kadar Awad asked. I should probably read it. He says, how do you think you have changed as a person since you first started posting videos on YouTube and made a business out of it? So this is quite a question and something that I don't often think about, but when I do think about it, it's pretty amazing. So I've said this before, but posting YouTube videos has made me be a better person. And you know, what I mean by that is it's not that I was like a big like crap head before I started posting YouTube videos, but posting YouTube videos has made me really kind of look at myself in terms of the type of man that I am, the things that I do, and the consequences of my actions. And the main reason this happened was because, you know, when I started posting YouTube videos, I didn't know, subscribers, I had no idea. Like, I was just posting stuff and I was doing what I was doing. And one of the things that I was doing, though, however, was kind of being, I was looking at what else was popular on YouTube and thought that if I wanted to be successful on this platform, I needed to be outlandish, I needed to be racy, I need to say things that would cause like a little bit of controversy. Now, this was back in like 2008 and 9 when, you know, it was kind of like the Wild West. Like, you could say whatever you wanted, there were no real restrictions, there was nothing. There wasn't like, you know, any type of like YouTube like policing that like there is now. And the people that were growing, the people that were popular, were the people that were really racy. And so I thought that that's what I needed to do. And I started posting videos, and I was, you know, some of the videos when they started were like super like PC and normal, and I was just talking about like how to tie a Windsor knot and stuff like that. But then I was like, okay, let me take it a little bit edgier. And so I did that. It didn't really work for me. It also felt a little bit creepy. And I ended up taking all those videos down. And, you know, things really changed for me on the platform when I decided to just sort of drop the act and be vulnerable and be me and just be normal and let people sort of get to know the real me. Now, one of the things that happened is that I realized that I had the ability to actually make a difference. And I also realized that I had people that were looking to me to sort of, you know, they were looking at me as a role model, which was something I had never been before. And it was something that when I first realized that, like, wait a second, people are actually listening to like what I have to say. And so I need to be a little more careful about the things that I say. It was scary, honestly. I got scared. I literally remember the feeling of, oh crap, you know, what am I gonna do? And what happened as a result of this was I felt like it was an incredible responsibility. And so I didn't want to, honestly, when I really think about things, I didn't want to let you down. I didn't want to let the people watching me down. I didn't want to be a hypocrite. I didn't want to come and say one thing to you and then turn around and do something else. I didn't ever want to be in a position where I'm saying that, like talking to you and being like, be a good person, do this, don't drink and drive, don't do stupid shit, right? Be a decent dude, right? And I don't want anybody to be able to like, you know, meet me out or see me somewhere or me do something that is contradictory to what I'm saying, because that's the thing that really upset me. You know, there are a lot of people out there, you know, celebrities that, you know, will say one thing, but then you see them and they're a crap head or they're a jerk or they're doing things that are contrary or contradictory to the message that they're putting out there. And it is such an incredible disappointment. I never wanted to be a hypocrite. So as a result of that, I sort of tightened up my act. I realized that if I am going to come on here, talk to you about being a certain type of person, I needed to walk the walk and not just talk, you know, talk the talk. Now, am I perfect? No. Do I still do things that I'd probably be embarrassed about if you knew that I did them? Yeah, of course. I'm human. But I try. And I try the best that I can in order to be the best person I can, not for me, but for you. I'm hyper aware of my actions and, you know, the things that I do, the things that I say. And so that is probably the number one biggest thing that's changed since I started posting videos was that I try to be a better person. I try anyway. Sometimes I guess I am, sometimes I'm not. You know, in terms of some other things that have changed for me, you know, when I started posting videos, I was just coming off of like a bankruptcy. I was completely broke. I was starting, you know, an image consulting business, and I started doing YouTube videos just to be like, hey, you know, this is a platform. And the thing that I've been seeking my entire life wasn't money, it wasn't fame, it wasn't anything like that. It was validation. It was making a difference. It was feeling like my opinion mattered. It was feeling like I was worth something. And I think from a very young age, that was the thing that I had been searching for my entire life. Now, as I've continued to, you know, post videos and create, you know, businesses around the content and around the platform, you know, other things have changed in my life. You know, it's no secret that I probably am more financially, you know, stable now than I was when I started. I won't say probably. I'm more financially stable now than when I started. You know, I often think, though, to myself, I wonder, I'm like, am I, you know, the same person that I was when I was broke? You know, I drive a nicer car now. I've got more money in the bank. But have I changed in terms of, has money changed me? It's changed certain aspects of my life, but I truly feel, and I say this, but you can probably tell that I'm a little bit like uncomfortable with this, but I like to think that it hasn't changed who I am in terms of a person and my character. I like to think that anyway, but I don't know. Honestly, I can't say that, you know, I can't say that for 100% fact. Now, one thing that I do feel is that I'm a pretty down-to-earth person, and that has not changed. But, you know, there's a downside to making money. Let me tell you, it's not all, you know, roses and just fast cars and women. It's there's some downsides that come with it, a lot more responsibilities. And as things start to grow and you know, there's some downside, and here's the other negative to, you know, being successful is that, you know, you're always aware. At least I am, and that's the thing I think that has not changed. I am always aware, and I'm still fearful that at a blink of an eye, one wrong decision, one stupid mistake, it all could go away. And that's something that is like in my head. I am always like hyper aware. And so that's one of the other reasons why, you know, I try not to do stupid things. I try not to just react. I try to think through things and protect the brand, protect the things that I've worked for incredibly hard. But I'm always aware that, you know, most of us, we are like one or two bad decisions from being completely broke and like literally living on the street. And so that's something that in the back of your head, when you're always worried about that, you live a little bit differently than just carefree and just, you know, going out and doing stupid shit because you don't have any consequences or there are no consequences to your actions. I think that a lot of people that find success early in life are at a disadvantage. But, you know, when I started, you know, posting videos, I was well into my 30s, you know, and so, you know, I had a life prior to this. I had, you know, a good life, but I also had some real struggles. For the majority of my life, I struggled, to be honest. So anyway, that is the long and short answer to the question. Yes, I've changed some things for the better, some things for the worse, but it's very difficult, I think, to look at yourself or your situation or who you are as a person objectively. I think your friends, your family, people that have known you for years would probably be better at determining that and being honest, but that's what I got. The other thing I got is another business question from our friend Gelmir Langtigua, and this question is incredible. He says, when starting Pete and Pedro, did you have one manufacturer or several to produce the products that you sell? And so what are the pros and cons? And if so, what are the pros and cons of your personal experience of having one manufacturer or more than one? So both Pete and Pedro and T. Shanley, one manufacturer when we started. Now, both Pete and Pedro, T. Shanley, multiple manufacturers. You know, when you're starting out, it's hard to like, you know, it's hard to find one manufacturer and to figure everything out and the logistics surrounding one manufacturer. But both, like I said, Pete and Pedro and T. Shanley, when we started, that's what we had. So we worked with that. But it was very quick that we realized you need to have a little bit of bench strength when it comes to your manufacturer. Because if something happens, you know, if like with T. Shanley, right, the PM moisturizer smelled fishy. Why? Because the manufacturer had marine collagen that was like funky, right? It wasn't that it was bad, but it smelled funky, causing our products to smell funky. The more and the bigger that we get, the more you realize, or let me back, the bigger that you get, the more you're going to realize how scary it is just having one manufacturer, because for God forbid, if something goes wrong with that one, you as a business is totally effed, right? You're done, because, you know, this one manufacturer, if they mess something up or they get shut down or if COVID happens and boom, everybody gets sick and you're left there like, what do I do? It is better to have multiple vendors if you can. But when you're starting, chances are you're probably only going to, you know, you're going to be lucky to have one good one. But yeah, and as you grow, you also are going to have different, you know, needs as a business. And so that's been one of the other things that you're going to have to figure out. So as you grow, you are going to have to probably look for multiple vendors for your specific product. But it takes time, you know, changing a vendor or trying to find a second vendor is going to take time. It's going to take energy. It's going to take money in order to vet them and figure out if they can actually do what you need them to do. But incredible question. The last business question I want to get to is from our friend Steve Strait. For the record, if you've got a business question down below, start it with business question and then ask your question. Next week, I'm going to try to get to some more of your business questions. I love answering your business questions. This one is another kind of personal one, business question. He says, Aaron, congratulations. Bah, bah, bah. All right. He says, I don't know what the church will be. And for the record, the church is actually going to be opening. Let me think. Hold on. By the time you're watching this, it's going to be open. We're opening in like December 8th. December 8th is the opening date. So at that point, I guess it's safe to actually tell you what it is. That's been really stressful. It has been really stressful. And I'll tell you a little bit about that and more about that soon. Sorry, I went down the rabbit hole. I need to order the dumpster. I need to do some things. Anyway, he says, Steve Strait, question. He says, I don't know what the church will be, but would you consider opening a grooming lounge? I'm sure I'm not the first person to ask you because you partly own the Pete and Pedro hair products. Don't partly own. I own it. 100%, baby. Anyway, and Tiege Hanley Skincare. That, I own part of that. Company as well. So next possible thing in my mind would be to open a grooming lounge for men or something similar. And if that is not the church project, would you ever consider it as a business idea? Thanks in regard. So would I open a grooming lounge for men? And the answer is no, I wouldn't. And that is not what the church is, for the record. But, you know, but it's a great idea, you know, and I can understand how that would be a very logical sort of thing for me to do. You know, but there are some downsides to dealing with men in that type of environment. There was actually a real grooming lounge that was started by the Grooming Lounge, the company, down here in Atlanta years ago. It was in this like really beautiful high rise called the Terminus Building. And I had known about the Grooming Lounge just from being a customer of the Grooming Lounge. I was not yet sponsored by the Grooming Lounge. I've done a bunch of, you know, videos for the Grooming Lounge. I actually went up to DC to meet the founder, Mike Gilman, and have the Grooming Lounge experience where I went in, they sold a bunch of products. I went in for a shave. I think they also do like haircuts and things of that nature. Yeah, they definitely do haircuts. And that is right like downtown, like DC. And the business I know personally, because I know sort of a little bit of the backstory, it's a tough business. It's a tough market. There have also been other places like, you know, what was that one that was like directly across the street? The Art of Shaving. The Art of Shaving, another business that is tailored and marketed to men to go in, get your cut, buy your products. So kind of like a grooming lounge experience. I think that business is actually shut down. It's tough, right? You need a lot of customers. The other downside to dealing with men is that they are more price sensitive typically than women, right? Like a men's haircut, you know, how much could you charge for a haircut? Even if you offer like amazing customer service and everything, like 40 bucks, 50 bucks maybe, you need a lot of them. But a woman, right, a woman is going to be, you know, an average ticket price for a woman is going to be around like $120 to $130. Women are a better market in terms of beautification, lounge type things because they are more willing to spend a higher price point and more money on services like that. You know, do I think it's a bad idea? No. Do I think there are places out there that are probably working? There was another place called like Hammer and Nail or something like that I heard of. I think I saw it even like on Shark Tank or something. There are lounges specifically designed for men that cater to men. And I'm sure that some of them do well, but it's a volume thing, right? You need a lot of people or you need to charge a membership fee in order to have access to it and make it more of like a private club type of situation. And both of those things are not something that I would be interested in getting involved in. It's easier to sell things to dudes online as opposed to like in person. But it could work. It could totally work. So if that's your dream, don't say, yo, Alpha wouldn't do it. Alpha just wouldn't do it because Alpha is scared of brick and mortar businesses. Alpha also knows how much easier it is to have online businesses. But apparently, that being said, I'm still interested in starting a brick and mortar business because I am, and I'll tell you more about that later. If you've watched this vlog long enough, there was a vlog where I actually said I would be open to starting a specific type of business. You remember what that was? Is that the business I'm opening? Maybe so. Gentlemen, I know right now, go look. Anyway, guys, that is where I'm going to wrap things up. You are amazing. I hope you had an incredible holiday. I hope you have an opportunity to grab the mega box. Gentlemen, once again, this is down below. $59.99, regular retail price, like $125. It is 50, literally like over 50% off. Guys, we love you more than our double monk trap shoes. And like I said, if you've got a business question down below, hit it. And hopefully next week I won't change too much. I'm kidding. I can't change. You keep me honest. Gentlemen, you are the best and amazing. And honestly, you're the reason why I am trying to be a better person. So thank you for that. You've changed my life. Literally and figuratively. Guys, thanks so much. We'll see you next week.